school board put it.
It's not in that, you know.
It may not.
Renovation.
Is there money in that?
No, no, zero.
So he didn't put that. I have no idea where he stuck it.
$50,000, not how much it fits on. They told me, that's in the last.
So same as well.
Said, if I didn't start getting that. Say, you can send a report in once a month about the money you spent. Said they didn't get away to get that order, said you didn't get all that coming down, packing money up. I guess I better do that.
Nothing, not funny. You all right?
It's the same every week, it's such a same report. Same every week, it's just much the same report.
Yeah, what's that now?
No, I didn't see it at the bottom. Change things up, huh?
Ago, he wanted me to go up there and haul some gravel up to Gundale for the Forest Service. Whenever we get together, and that's last 2 years. I ain't seen him on the road tonight.
You see him since last week?
Really? He just stayed with the house.
Yes, he does. He's doing something.
His wife's about to buzz.
There you go.
All right, thank you. Thank you. Got tied up on us last week, didn't you?
Oh, yes.
Here's something from the governor. You got a copy of that? Oh, a few pennies your way.
I knew about this. I didn't get this one.
You have it out there.
I didn't get this one, but I know that. I got one from the township up here. So I knew. It's all the same thing, so I knew this from somewhere, but first time they've done that.
Well, this is better received than that to give. That part of it, anyway. How's everything going out there? Holding chip underway, about
done? Back at it. That was our problem last week. Our distributor was not right. We fought it for a week or better. Last Tuesday about 3:15. Finally figured out what was going on. And so we were back going then Wednesday, and then Thursday the chip sprint. We worked on it for a day and finally pumped us for it.
When you get out and volunteer, do you wash it out with basement?
What you do is you really don't wash it out. Keep it out. You just put some diesel in there. And start, and yeah, let it set the diesel. That's like our pumps we use the salt brine. Whenever we end up to you, we put windshield wipers in. Yeah. Just leave it in there. It's cheaper and it's non-toxic. Either windshield antifreeze or RV antifreeze, one of the two, they're fairly economical. Hey, they keep them from freezing up, and you keep the liquid in there to keep
from staying up. Yeah.
That's the main thing, is just rubbing
something. Larry, the chairman, or Bob Munford, called you about all chicken and bird. I asked him, I said, well, now, the chairman's on. I said, is that county road system? I believe it is. Well, I put gravel on myself. I don't know what.
I've never known it to be. I've talked to her. Yeah, I've never known it to be. And she said, well, we're not saying it is. We've only been here 13 years. And I said, well, I've known it for about over 25, and it hasn't been. And I've got to go back. I told him I would go back and look at old maps, but I don't ever remember it being. She says, well, it was on a chip one time. I said, well, the developer or the residents might have done that years ago.
Yeah.
Because Linda May used to do that sort of work for a while. He had the drivers and
Short Brothers still do that.
I think Short Brothers does it. And they have done better work. They did some one time, but I wasn't very. Wasn't for us, but it was in a subdivision. I knew what they had done, and I wouldn't accept it. And the subdivision developer is a fine fellow. And I said, we're going to see what happens this winter. And you saw what happened that winter. It didn't hold up, and he had to redo it the next spring. And now we've got the subdivision. And he says, had to pay as much to have it redone as what I had to do to begin with. I'm not surprised. But no, I think Short Brothers has done much better work.
But maybe not.
Their problem is that. That's why I knew about it. I let them store their chips on the yard. They brought their chips in and stored them in the yard. Come to the yard and pick them up and blow them. Wait a minute. So I watched and see where they went with it.
Have you heard him for very well? Did they ever sign those papers? Or no, Gavin has the railroad bridge.
Yeah. The contract's awarded for three jobs next Tuesday. So I will be, if I make it next Tuesday, it'll be very quick and short. Because I've got to get Carbondale by 11 o'clock. So I don't know. I tried to call.
You came in early.
There'll be no claims or anything. So it'd just be I'll come in a ways with you in case you got something.
Yeah.
Get out of here so I can be there by 11. That's all. To be safe, usually I can do it about an hour and 10 minutes, but I like to leave a little extra.
Yeah.
Because you never know what you're going to get caught up on.
Larry, Miss, you know where Miss Iceland lives? There on Belgrade.
Yeah. I've talked to her. I've looked at it. Talked to her a second time.
I don't know. It's just a very small grade. I don't think it would have been effective, but she's putting money on the yard. She don't want that backed up in there.
Well, I'm kind of I'll take with the drought, I take all the water I can get right now. But she's got a point, and I told her that. And I understand, and I've talked to her twice. First time I looked at it, they had the ditch pretty well cleaned out. Then she called back and says they put more rock in the ditch. And so I went back down Thursday or Friday. Still, she said it was level, and it is, but I've got contact, I'm not sure, either Jerry or Warfield, whoever, but I've got to get in touch with him, and I haven't.
dish has a four foot on that property. It's theirs.
I have to look. I was under the impression of four feet.
Well, I think it's more for a family, but he's taking responsibility to own the woods, and he says it doesn't.
I don't either. I understood Warfield was going to be there.
I think they do.
I haven't talked to Jerry, but Jerry has been talking to him. He said he was going to clean it back out when he got done hauling gravel.
Yeah. I don't know. That's her mother.
That was between my two phone calls with her and then more gravel. You know, my firm had, between the two phone calls, more gravel showed up. That's why she called second. She said that rain last Monday backed water up into her yard. I thought, well, if I was trying to get grass going right now, I wouldn't mind a little rain in the yard open.
Well, that right water, I'm not good at that. Well, in time, I guess.
Yeah, but we get, if they're going to want to dry, they need to get
water. Now with a good problem.
The more water is, 12 inches. Carry it easy.
What kind of man clean that ditch out for? Will that be, you know, in the drain or at the top? I bet this about 7 inches deep.
No, it's deeper than that. I think you could probably pretty well crowd a 12-inch pipe in there. But I really don't think that no one's going to do it.
Well, it's just, yeah, I think that maintenance up there, son.
And if,
anyway, you know about it. So.
Yeah, I've been down there twice, and I'm not the only one. I've been down there twice, I know, looking at just that.
That's seen in the office. He looks like he's getting antsy to do something.
Well, would you?
Yeah.
And I just can't understand. It looks like to me this thing is healing wrong, and that just needs that much more that they're going to have to redo.
I don't ever remember anybody having to go through that. Or work with companies.
Oh. Well, no, I don't know. I know some people that's gone. I got a good friend that went through it on both shoulders.
Well, I'm not talking just that surgery, but just...
Did this take that long?
Yeah.
Did anything like with our insurance company?
It was for a while, but for the last month, it has been the doctor's office. Well, we can't get your skin to get sued.
So you're commercial, and like 3 months ago?
June. Middle of June. 2 months ago.
Yeah. What doctor?
This doctor?
No. I don't know if Patel's going to be the surgeon, and not this Patel.
Or the Peter Group of Medusa.
Something.
Yeah. I go to them, but my shoulders look myself.
I heard good
mayor. I know that you've seen a new facility. It also hangs in there with the college and FTC. So you turn in that same driveway that goes into that real nice, what is it, the funeral, the church, I guess.
Yeah.
Is that the flag? Is that what it is?
Yeah.
And it's right back
on the left.
Yeah. It's a huge facility.
I've heard good things about it, but
about
yes, that's what it is.
I mean, I've heard many replacements. He does. He's excellent.
I can never get into him. I have to go see his PA.
But yeah, he brings to Dr. Patel and I says, he going to do it? And he says, no. Dr. Patel is his doctor there, and he was talking to Dr. Patel.
Patel over there, a different Dr. Patel, who has a surgeon.
When I called him, made my phone back in April, it was 4 months. I said, so what do you want to go see his physician? I said, oh, yeah. It was like 2 weeks after I saw him.
Yeah, the insurance company was holding it up for 2 or 3 weeks. I don't get that. We made some phone calls there. Finally, they said, hey, we cleared it. It's up to the doctor now. I mean, just...
cheap deal.
I understand.
I found a cheap Volkswagen in my dollars.
Smaller.
Were they like in pallets?
Yeah.
V6s?
Yeah, front wheel drive V6. Which V6? 3800?
I have no idea. Mary says what they've used for the last several years and they like it.
If it's a 3800, best engine, best car I've ever had, and had almost 200,000 miles, could hit up the interstate, get 28, 29 miles a gallon, 70 miles. I bought a van after I sold that, and I wished I could have gotten the 3800 and had it 3.4, up 22 miles an hour. Best thing to do. Best thing to do was 22 miles an hour.
You've done good.
Well, that 3800, I'm serious. Had that. Could head up the interstate at 70 miles an hour. 28.
Good one.
Larry,
be careful out there.
We try.
Ted, you don't remember, in 1962.
Barely.
Yeah. Sidney bought a 62 Ram. Do you remember that, John?
It did the white one.
Yeah, white one, yeah.
As a matter of fact, it was still here when I started.
Really?
Yeah, they used it. The SBA fella used it for a while.
Sure did. Well, that...
I remember the old Rambler.
Yeah. They got that somebody in town, did 30 miles an hour in a city block, a lot of things. So, it wasn't long, but that was it.
Are you going to leave it black and white and blue?
Yeah, same strap to me, he's got on his,
it's sharp. What do y'all need specifically for me?
I've got three other cars, got over 150,000, I'm sure they're taking out, putting in these, to see how they work. Hey, if they work out okay, I'm not going to work. $4,500 a car. The last 2 years is worth that.
We're a big platform. That's
in the ratings.
That's all we did.
That one drop as well. That was just a spare of the vehicle. Like, trying to set it to work for you.
They had like bucket seats in front of the engine.
that I've highlighted, Sandy said that you could pay some of those for part of what's there. Just make part of it.
Your balance was, this one to do, $49,000.
I don't know if you've heard about it, but to have anybody here tell me that light was bright last Thursday night. I asked the guy for a ballpark figure, and he said ballpark's going to be $100,000. He said it could be 50, it could be 150. But everything, I don't know if you've ever been in a radio room, but when you leave the console, it goes back to the radio room where circuit boards are. The circuit boards for every radio, there's 16 radios. And there it goes to the building back here, the actual radio room. But in Friday, 13 circuit boards. $5,000 to $6,000 a piece. The cabin that they were in was probably $30,000 cabin. They got back into the radio room before I had some radios. So right now, call the insurance company, they're going to get them all rolling. And I don't know if they're going to replace the system that we've got, or if they're going to do the radio system. The problem with replacing what we've got is if we have another lightning strike, it's going to do the same thing.
What can you do to prevent that, or anyway? I thought I read in the tropics right from the city was doing something different.
They got their building fine. Jim Walters, the next week we got to get it in. I was told that the ground's too dry and the towers are bringing in the electricity. I really don't know.
Is this a tower that's going out there?
Then it was in computers, then it was in phones, the TVs, and this got the radio. There is the IP, internet protocol-based stuff, so everybody knows it now. There's a new radio system that's out there that basically do away with the surfing tools. All you have is a computer and software program. So if the lightning comes through again, it blew it up, you just blow the computer, you can replace it for $800 and get back online. But that's going to be up to the insurance.
Why is it, if that thing would be struck a lot more lightly, you know, for years there, I didn't. Maybe once or so in several years. Now it's been hit about 3 times this year right now.
So I would some people say it's the condition of the ground, there's kind of moisture in the ground to dissipate the lightning, or it's just the intense lightning. But ours, the city BE's got a super hit.
And you're speaking there of basically what amounts to just a fuse, inline fuse, to keep electricity running and everything. You're talking about a piece of equipment, basically a fuse, and blow it instead of everything. I should have removed this problem.
The new system is it's going to do away with it. They won't have circuit boards. It's just the internet stuff through the fiber optic wires. You just won't have a computer. If it hits it, you just take that computer out and put the new in.
So, the computer is basically a fuse, and it will just wipe it out instead of everything else or anything.
It's going to do away with it.
So who's been the person that's been doing the work for us?
Actually, purchase.
But there's, like Billy admitted, is there no way that they can have that lightning go over a path that stops there, he said a fuse or something, instead of making it to a certain panel and stuff, that it will stop at that instead of going further through the system?
Could do it. You would think when it comes into the building, it would hit everything. And it's not, it's just going through the radio bar, basically. Some other times it might come through cable TV. I don't have stuff. They're working on it just like the city's working on theirs to try to find a way to get around it. Sometimes you just can't stop.
Right, our insurance company's on the rescue office. That's been a lot of fun. Thanks.
Jim Walter did some work for him. I said the last time, I don't think that worked. I mean, it might have helped some.
It looks like you could have a ground coming off of the main line and a fuse there, a bullet of fuse, and you could send that ground. But
that's what
it's so fast, maybe it wouldn't do that.
Surely if those rods drilled in the ground like they do with pumps.
Well, they're part of the alarm. I don't exactly know that. way they built the stuff wired in, the city took over a lot of the radios, which is pretty
good.
911 is just good. It's up to where we can answer calls, a lot of the information that pops up when you call in is not there, goes up to the public system as well, so we can still take it to city hall.
Pretty cool, and under the test.
There's something last week we handled with this one. Hard candy concerts all the way, so we can do it.
Well, in that, I'm right, wasn't watching much, I didn't even, was this that clown posse or?
Yeah, it's that clown posse.
You didn't go, did you?
No. Not my cup of tea.
I wanted to. It's probably going to have your history, there was a traffic, and it was a parking lot, terrible.
Why, is it a big time trial or what?
It was from here. We have a last week, we've got one starting yesterday, it's been 2 weeks, and I have to have two other criminal trials, so next month, it's going to be every night. Picking jurors, and I think we're looking at 100 people in the hall.
Oh, my God. They were just stacked in there.
Good, wasn't it?
I tell you what, though, I got to looking out, seeing jurors out there, and they were all little kids, you know, doing this job. They're
still in high school, and
my kids are here.
Yeah, that's cool, man, but it's changing over. Ricky Gower was out there. Ricky was holding court, and he was ready to leave. They weren't getting to it faster. One of the agents takes her in his office and says, well, at least Ricky's not to fight yet.
He needs to kick back and enjoy life. He's a long one.
That's what he enjoys.
Yeah, I know he really enjoys it. He likes it. That's what keeps him going. I understand that.
I never met him, but I went up there with a contractor. He's one of them. Tear the old one down, get away by the door. He's good.
Talk about it.
Thank you, Chad. Be careful.